Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. This is your lady, and I wanted to share with you all this notebook planner slash journal that I did. Now, I don't do planning, but I do love making the books. So I decided to play a little bit with different materials here. Now, I use this die set from Kiescraft. Now, Kiescraft has an Amazon store, and I will let the link in the description box below so you can check it out, what they have already in Amazon. Now, remember when you have a Amazon store, they send everything to the warehouse, and from there, they can ship. So it will be a lot more faster in the shipping concept of it than when you go to the AliExpress store. So, this is the die set, and this is the flower die set from the planner. And I use this die set, and I actually use a new material that you cannot find here in the US. Well, now there are two stores that are bringing Spain produce to the US. One store is in California, and the other one is in Puerto Rico, but they ship to the States as well. So there are two stores that actually ship here, but I want to give you, you know, a little bit of tricks on there, here and there. Now, this is called Ecopierre, the material, and it's beautiful. You see the texture of it is very beautiful. And what it is like a very thin leather, faust leather, synthetic leather. But what happened? That is so thin that you can actually work very easy with it, because you can make covers for mini albums or other 3D projects. And because it's very thin, you can actually bend and fold in corners and all that stuff without no problem. Let's see, this is the corner of a mini book, and you can actually do all of this and without no problem, and it has no wrinkles, anything. It's very, very easy to work with. So this is the texture of it. It has like hair kind of texture. This is the back side. It's very clean and very easy to work with. You can glue it with fabric tan or with paper glue. So it's with white glue. It's super, super easy to work with. So this is the one that I use now. This is called Ecopierre, and it's expensive. It's like $750 just a piece of 30 centimeters by 20 centimeters. So it's quite expensive. So before I found this, because the Ecopierre, when I saw the Ecopierre on the videos that I was watching from Cora Projects and all the stuff, I saw it and I could find it here in the US. It was very hard because you had to pay shipping from Spain to the US, and it's super expensive. So I was like, oh no. So I went to AliExpress. I know, I went there and I went looking for something that it was similar to the product, and I found this. Now I bought it in different colors. So you can see the texture of this. This is like a skin texture, like it's very beautiful. It's very beautiful. And I got it in ivory color. This is ivory color. And in the back, it's different from the real tin, like the brand tin. You see the back, but the back you are not going to see it. And it's the same, even thinner than the other one. So it's so much easier to work with. It's super easy. So I wanted to show you that this project that I did, this camera, I use actually the one from AliExpress, because I could not find any here in the US in that time. So now that these ladies are bringing products from Spain, you can find it. But what you can, this is cost like $1 something, and this one costs $7.50. So you see price right is a lot cheaper, the AliExpress version of it, because you just need two of these to make a one of these with a little bit left over. So two of these is more than the one sheet that sells for $7.50, and two of these is like almost $2 something. So yeah, so it's a lot more affordable for us. Now you can find like the faust leather on the craft store, like Hobby Lobby and Joann's, I guess. I got this in Hobby Lobby. What happened is that this is thicker, So to make like projects, like mini album covers and everything, it's very hard because it made so much bulk that it's very hard to bend the corners. You know, those spaces that is more like the corners of a mini album, it's very hard to make because of it. So yes, yeah, so it's pretty difficult to work with that one because it's too thick. So yeah, so that's one of the things that I wanted to share with you all in case you want to work with this kind of material. I will let the link description box below to these Facebook groups that sell the material here in the US, the one from Puerto Rico and the one from California. It's no sponsor or anything like that. I just think that if you want to work with this material, why not give you the information, right? And I also going to let you the information from AliExpress or this place that I found mine. I found the pink one. This pink one that you see here, I got blue one and I got this ivory one that you see here, the ivory one. I also got this one here that is like jelly kind of, it's called jelly something, and it's like this one. And I got this one in this color and in pink as well. So yeah, so you can choose any color that you want because they have a lot of color schemes. So yeah, so you can choose from there. So, okay, so let's go ahead with the notebook inside. Now, these rings, I got it from AliExpress as well, and I thought it was very cute. I love them. The only problem that I have with them is that it's just 1 inch circle, so you don't get the bigger one. So, when I want to do like a chunky mini album or something like that, you know, when I decorate the inside, I cannot do it because, oh, I cannot fill it with too many pages because it will end like too bulky in this part over here. So that's why. But yeah, but you just want it for journaling and stuff like that. 1 inch, it will be good for you. So yeah. So in the front cover, I use this lace from René Bouquet's. I have my stash. It's super beautiful. And then I got this beautiful flower from Rosa Gomez, who is Creative Way here in YouTube. And I will let it in the description box below because she does sell this in the stashes and kits and stuff like that. So yeah, so it's very beautiful. I just put one because I don't want it to overdo the cover, so it will be easy to grind the back side of it. Now here I put layers of the design paper that I use. I use Chavy Rose paper, digital paper from my shop. I will let the description box below. And here I just put a picture of me, but it's to give you an idea that you can personalize the front cover with your own picture. So I just put mine there. So just to give you know, to give you like an idea of how you can use it. So it opens like this. Let me take this out, the pen. So you open like this and it has this magnet here. Now it closed. I have to now. Now it closed very nicely. So when you open it, I made a pocket in this side over here. And look at the texture of the Eco Piel, it's beautiful. So here I put like a clip that says hello and some layers just to decorate. And here you can put the paper clips in these lines in here. You can put the paper clips. And I put a pocket here with this. This is one of the layers of the die set that came in top of this one here. So I just cut three of them and I just put it there. And then I just put this clip in this hole in here. So that's how you can put, you know, you can put your own clips in there as well. So this is a like a guy. So I just put it there and I open the holes in here so you can remove it and put it somewhere else. I just put this like a guy for the squares of the page in case you need like a guy to write or something like that. So this is the first page here. And I don't do anything. I just decorate this part, the front, the base, and then the design, and then this one case in top of it. This is how it comes. So what it is, I just let it with the design part, and this is one of the design papers from the Chavy Rose paper kit. And yes, that's what I did. Then I use these dots here, so you can like do lettering or something like that. I made a lot of those pages, as you can see here. Then here is another divider, and I did the same thing just with the design paper or the same kit. Here is the base with this is just plain paper, the copy paper. So that's what I did. Here is another divider. And you can journal here and put pictures in here and all that stuff. Here is another part here with the dots as well. And this is like in gray cardstock. Sorry, it's so hard to do it all with one hand. So here is the other divider. And here is just, again, copy paper. And you can see all the pages there. Here is another divider, more copy, this is cardstock. A white cardstock, and here is the back side with two pockets, as you can see here. It's two pockets, and I put these cutouts here. And this is from the other side. This is the same flower die set, but in the small size. So this is the same as this one over here. It's just that this is the big size, the regular size, and this is the small size of the journal. So let me show you. So this is the big one size, that this one that I use here, and this is the small size that I use the one of the parts, the cutouts parts for these pockets over here, these little papers here. But it came in two sizes. You see the big size and the small size. So that's all I did. Then I made like a pencil holder, and I got this one, this pen from the Dollar Tree, and I just put it there. You know, it's just very, very chunky because it has this pompon there. So yeah, so that's what I did, and I hope you like it. I think it's so cute. So I put like a little sample here, how it will look with, you know, when you fill it up. Now I had the worst hand lettering. Yeah, I'm super bad with my hand lettering. So I just tried to look like a sample how it will look when you fill it up and all that stuff. And so yeah, so I really had a lot of fun. I love making, like I say, I love making the books. I just don't, not good with filling them. I just don't worry in that. But I really do enjoy making them. And so yeah, so this is what I did. If you are interested, please send me a message here, a comment, or you can, I will let my information, my email and stuff like that, in case you are interested in it, because I have no problem selling it, because like I said, I love making them, but I don't feel them, so it's just gonna be in my drawers. So yeah, so it will be good to go to a beautiful home, to be filled up and, you know, use. So yeah, so here is the planner. And this is one of the drawings that I've been working on and been trying to work in the stands for a fall. So this was one of the ideas, and I colored how I picture it, how it will look. So I had as well the white and black, the draw too. So yeah, so it's something that I want to share soon. And so yeah, so that's what I've been working on. So yes, I hope you like it. I really had a lot of fun. Now the pictures I printed with my LG, and this is the printer. This is a pocket printer, and these are the pictures, the paper, and it came 3D here, 10 in each bag. So it came 3 bags, individual bags here, and in each bag it came 10. So I had 20 here, for 20 pictures, and I had the other 10 in my printer right now. So what you do is you download the app to your phone, and from your phone you print the pictures here. So it's very easy to do and print, and I print it on black and white. So yes, so that's something that you can use to personalize your journals or mini albums. Oh, there is a lot of other options as well in the websites, in Amazon, everywhere. So yeah, so that's just the one that I use. So remember, you can personalize this with your own picture and all that stuff. And yeah, so thank you so much for watching. I hope you have a wonderful day, and take care. I hope to see you very soon. Thank you. Bye.